My name is Thorsten von Overgaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world and photograph and teach photography. Today I'm going to talk about angle of view. You know lenses as 50 millimeter, or for example 90 millimeter, or 35 millimeter. And what's the difference? Well, the difference is angle of view. So a 50 millimeter will have a frame that goes something like this. A 35 is wider, and a 90 is more narrow. And of course, you can get a 200 or 400 or 800 millimeter lens where it's really narrow. And when you get up to a 400 millimeter lens, you're down to an angle of view of about 4 degrees. So why is it called 50 millimeter? Or why is it called 90 millimeter? So the reason that they came up with the name 50 millimeter for a lens with this angle of view is that the lenses are made by lens designers, and they're made more than 100 years ago. So the subject of photography wasn't really meant to be for any teenager or anybody with an iPhone. It was something that you almost have to wear a white kilt to deal with. So the way they figured out is that a 50 millimeter lens, there's 50 millimeters from the film or the center plane, which is around here in the camera, to the axis of focus inside the lens. And that means that a 90 millimeter lens, there's 90 millimeters from the center plane here to the axis of focus out here. So that's why it's called 90 millimeter, 50 millimeter, 400 millimeter. So you can almost say that the 400 millimeter lens is going to be 400 millimeter long, or usually a little bit longer. Then you have different optical designs, so you will have actually really big lenses that are only 21 millimeter, but that's a different story. When photography was new, it was pretty simple. It was almost 50 millimeter long lens, 90 millimeter long lens. In reality, if you think back to a pinhole camera, so that's like a plate with a small hole in it, that works as optics and as a camera in the old days. And that's basically the same we have here, but now we have optics in front of it. And we kind of enlarge and cut out. But in reality, if you take a 35 millimeter camera and you take a photo of a landscape, and if you crop in on the photo, that's basically the same as a 50 millimeter will see. Or you crop even further in, that's going to be what the 90 millimeter will see. So most of that is very similar. So there's one interesting thing in angle of view, and that is when you go with wide-angle lenses. Because if you look, you will see that your eye, you see something like an 8 millimeter lens, you see really wide. What you look at is usually in focus, and the rest is a little bit blurry, but I can actually see my hands out here, they're moving. So that's really wide. When you put on a wide-angle lens on a camera, then you start to get distortion, and you start to get lines going in weird directions. And you will see that if you take a photo here and I have this camera in front of it, then this camera is going to be distorted because it's in the bottom of the frame. When I look at you and I see the camera down here, I don't have any distortion. And that's simply just because the eye adjusts for distortion. So we have straight lines, and even if I tilt my head, all the lines are going to be straight and everything is nice. So that's one thing that you have to get used to. When you go wide angle, is that you have distortion. When you go tele lens, not a lot is happening, except that usually things behind the subject, so you focus on a person far away, then the background is almost pulled into the person. So that's also, you could say, an optical illusion or something that looks different than to the eye. Most cameras with fixed lens have either a 50 millimeter or a 35 millimeter as the standard lens. So that means standard lens means the one basically that most people use, and the one that you would use for most of what you do. Generally, most people tend to either like 50 millimeter or 35. So even if you have both lenses, you're still going to use maybe 50 millimeter 90% of the time. And the difference on lenses is simple. You could say you have wide angle and super wide angle lenses. So that's like 18, 21, 28, 35 millimeter. Then you get over to 50 millimeter. That is very close to how the eye sees things. And then you get over to small tele lenses like the 75, 90 millimeter, and 400 millimeter, 800 millimeter, 1600 millimeter, and up there. Often the 50 millimeter is referred to as the one closest to the eye, but the thing is that your eye sees wide angle, so the 50 millimeter only sees this. So it's not in that sense, but it's the size ratio that is the same, and that means that when you go wide angle, it feels like things are pushed away in the background behind the subject, whereas with telephoto, things in the background is pulled in to the camera. So that makes it look a little bit different than the eye. So 50 millimeter is the lens that is closest to how the eye sees things. That was my talk about angle of view and lenses. If you want to dig deeper into this, go to my website and buy my ebook, The Freedom of Photographic Expression. And if you want to go even deeper, then sign up for my extension course, the Thorsten Overgaard new extension course. It's both on my website. Also, a really good thing to do is go to my website and sign up for my free newsletter so you stay in the know with new articles about cameras, lenses, photography, and everything. And if you're really smart, you do it right now and you get a free ebook. Thank you, and see you next time.